The dotnet command line interface, or dotnet CLI, is a cross-platform tool for the modern development of dotnet applications. dotnet CLI enables developers to script, build, test, and publish processes in the continuous integration and continuous deployment strategy. By learning dotnet CLI, developers do not solely depend on Visual Studio and can use other IDEs and editors such as VS Code. I'm Mohammad, Sahebhonar, and in this video series, we are going to review the main .NET CLI commands. To follow along, I'm going to assume that you are already comfortable in programming with C#. Since I'm going to be using VS Code, I expect you are familiar with using VS Code to build programs. After all, you will need the .NET SDK installed. Okay, let's dive in. Although it is not necessary to have a solution, I'm going to create a solution folder. I will name the solution Product Management. As you noticed, the command starts with .NET driver, then the new command, followed by SLN argument, -o option, and its value, the name of the output directory. Let's paste the code into the terminal. We need to switch to the solution directory. Next, we want to add a new project to our solution. Here, we have the list of cross-platform templates. Based on the selected template, we can modify some common options. For instance, for an MVC template, we are able to change the type of authentication to apply or determine to use Razor runtime compilation in debug environments. I want to create a new web API project and call this project Product Management API. Minimal APIs are a new feature in .NET 6. Minimal APIs allow developers to create APIs with basically a single file where they can configure the application but also write the code of the endpoints. This Python-oriented C# is not my cup of tea. Maybe you become fond of this feature. Anyway, let's paste the code into the VS Code terminal. Next, we can add projects to the solution. I want to add the Product Management API project to the solution. Indeed, we need to provide the path to the project's csproj file. I'm going to paste the code into the terminal. To verify that the project has been added, let's take a look at the solution file. Before we move further, let's create a .NET class library project. We named it Product Management Entities. That targets .NET Standard Framework. At the time of recording this video, .NET Standard 2.1 is the latest version. Let's add the product management entities to the solution. We need another class library for our project. This time, the project targets .NET 6 framework, and we name it Product Management, EF Infrastructure. Let's also add this project to the solution. All right. Before we write code against the component of the entities project, our infrastructure project must first contain a reference to it. To add a reference, we use addReference command and provide the path to the source csproj file and the target csproj file. Let's take a look at the infrastructure csproj file. The reference has been added successfully. Now we need to install the Entity Framework Core NuGet package for the infrastructure project. Up to now, we have been working in the solution directory. As this guide shows, we need to switch the directory to the project folder that we want to install the NuGet package. Let's enter the EF Core package name. And paste the code in the terminal. You can specify the version of the NuGet package, otherwise the latest stable version will be installed. If you are interested in the pre-release versions, you can check this option. We have already used the .NET new command to create a project. We can use the same command to add additional items to our project. Based on the item we want to add, we may need to change the directory. For example, we are going to add a git ignore file to the project. So I need to change the working directory to the solution directory and run the command. We reached the end of this video. In the next video, I will explain how to build and test .NET projects. Thank you for watching, everyone.